Welcome to USDTL's umbilical cord drug testing tissue collection video. This video will walk you through each step for correct collection of umbilical cord specimen while maintaining a proper chain of custody. We will cover the steps for both targeted and universal collection. The collection method used will be determined by your organization's policy. Collecting umbilical cord for drug testing has many advantages over the collection of meconium. Umbilical cord is available for collection immediately following birth, which allows for quicker shipment to the laboratory for results. Meconium may take several days to be sent to the laboratory. Umbilical cord collection takes approximately 2 minutes to complete and is easily done in the delivery room. At the time of collection, there is plenty of specimen for testing, which eliminates unnecessary rejections at the lab due to insufficient quantity for analysis. Umbilical cord specimens are available for every birth. Up to 22% of meconium specimens are unavailable due to stress during gestation. This stress factor is often related to maternal substance abuse, which may lead to the passage of meconium in utero. The collection protocol is a simple, single collection procedure, eliminating the multiple cumulative collections required with meconium. This means there is one collector and one collection, greatly improving the integrity of the chain of custody by avoiding multiple collections by multiple collectors. Umbilical cord testing has demonstrated improved sensitivity for detection of drugs of abuse. For these reasons, we are excited to convey proper umbilical cord specimen collection for your organization. Now, let's get started. Begin the collection by cutting a 6-inch section of the umbilical cord. Any section of the umbilical cord is appropriate. Pinch the specimen between the finger and thumb, then run your fingers down the specimen 3 to 4 times to drain excess blood. Discard any excess blood. Rinse the exterior of the specimen with normal saline or isotonic rinsing solution. Water should be avoided. Caution: prevent the umbilical cord from coming in contact with ethanol-based liquids or vapors previous to and during the collection process. This includes ethanol-based hand sanitizer and alcohol prep pads. Pat the specimen dry and place it in the specimen container. At this point, we should address two common policies for ordering newborn drug screens. The first policy is the targeted collection. This means that at or near the time of delivery, the decision has already been made to order a drug test on this particular newborn. The second policy is the universal collection. This means that a collection is performed at every delivery. The specimens are stored locally under chain of custody, and the decision to test can be made at any time thereafter. The policy of your organization affects how the chain of custody is initiated and documented. For the targeted collection, place the newborn's ID number on the specimen container. The newborn's name is optional. The ID number may be the medical record number, hospital laboratory accession number, or any other unique identifying number of the collection facility's choosing. The hospital patient ID sticker may be utilized to satisfy this step. Fill out the custody and control form. Please verify that the pre-printed company information is correct in the client section of the form. Place the newborn's ID number on the custody and control form in the patient donor section. The newborn's name is optional. Mark the umbilical cord specimen type box. Mark the test or tests requested to be performed in the tests requested section. Check all that apply. USDTL can pre-mark forms at your organization's request. The specimen container must be sealed with a tamper evidence seal. Match and verify the newborn's information on the custody and control form with the newborn's information on the specimen container. peel off one of the barcoded tamper evidence specimen seals located at the bottom of the custody and control form. Place the barcoded tamper evidence seal over the cap. Failure to place a tamper evidence seal over the cap will result in a rejected specimen that the lab will be unable to process. Initial and date the tamper evidence specimen seal. Print, sign, and date in the Collector Processor Certification section of the Custody and Control Form. The Sendouts section is optional, based on individual hospital policies and procedures. Place the original white copy, labeled Lab Copy, of the Custody and Control Form in the large pouch of the plastic specimen bag provided. Place the sealed specimen container in the small pouch of the specimen bag and seal the specimen bag. Place the sealed specimen bag in the transport box provided and close the box. Place the specimen box in an appropriate courier transport overwrap. Contact your courier for pickup. Specimens should be kept refrigerated in a secure area until they are ready to be shipped. For universal collections, use one of your hospital urine specimen containers and affix the hospital patient ID sticker and a standard security seal over the top of the specimen container. Sign and date the seal. Place the specimen container in a refrigerator for temporary storage. The individual placing the specimen in the fridge should fill out the log sheet with their signature, date, and time. The designated temporary refrigerated storage should be located in a limited access area. Once the decision has been made to test or destroy the specimen, the party responsible for removing the specimen from the fridge will log out the specimen on the log sheet with a signature, date, and time next to the specimen information. The length of time the specimen is held in storage is up to the organization. Refrigerated specimens are good for up to 3 weeks. At this point, if the specimen is to be tested, proceed with the same steps that were covered for the targeted collection once the specimen container was sealed. Fill out the custody and control form, initial and date the barcoded tamper evidence seal, then place it over the container. Try not to overlap the seals so that all information remains legible. Thank you for watching our collection training video. If you have additional questions, please feel free to contact our client services department at 800-235-2367 or email them at clientservices@usdtl.com.